we're in conversation with David Abraham and Rakesh Thakore from the brand Abraham and Thakore. Thank you so much for your time, gentlemen.
Thank you.
So, if you had to define your brand in three words, what would those three words be?
Oh gosh, that's not going to be easy. Three words. I can give you, they were a bit cliched, but clean.
Simple. Timeless.
Timeless, okay.
So both of you met at NID and you started your brand in the year 1992. Why did you decide to collaborate?
I think we were both at a point when we really didn't have anything, we didn't have any work. I think it was a matter of necessity. So that's the reason why we were both at a particular place at a particular time when we needed to do something, and so we started Abraham and Thakore.
You've been in the business for so long and you've seen so many young designers emerge over the years. According to you, what is required from a label to make a statement in the fashion industry and also to sustain for over a decade?
I think it's largely got to be to stay focused and more importantly, I think believe in yourself in terms of what you're doing and stay in that direction.
I personally have seen in the last 10, 11 years, so many designers who are talented, but either some kind of, you know, they get into a cycle of depression or excessive competition or lack of market and they kind of drop out of the race. So what is really required as a designer to stay in the industry for long? Or you think it's part of the journey that somebody is going to
drop out? Part of the journey, I think. Some people can. And some people can't.
Some survive, some don't.
Exactly. Yeah.
But any advice you would give on how to survive in the fashion industry?
Just to be there and be strong and sort of, you know, firm enough to continue.
Yeah, I think you have to believe in yourself. You've also got to be, I think, what the most important things, which I don't see enough of very often, but that's not just here, it's anywhere in the creative industries, the willingness to change and adapt. You can't get stuck in, you can't create one particular statement or vision and just stick with it for 20 years. It's not possible. If you can't, don't keep reinventing yourself, the business just requires, you have to reinvent yourself.
So you've, at which point do you think you guys reinvented yourself?
I think we've every season.
Every collection, hopefully.
Exactly.
And tell us about your current collection.
A lot of the fabrics that we use in the current collection are basically hand-woven, specially. And both come in mixes of cotton and cotton silk textures with a lot of cut work that you've, particularly the one that you're wearing, comes from Banaras.
What do you have to say about the fashion quotient of the following Bollywood stars? Sonam Kapoor.
I mean, she's a pretty girl who spends all the time getting dressed.
Okay.
And seems in beautiful clothes.
And she seems to be changing like her outfit like what 10 times a day. So. All
and she enjoys that, I guess.
All luck to her. I mean, if that's the way she wants to spend her day. I think she makes money out of it.
I'm sure she does.
Yeah, then it's fine.
Kareena Kapoor Khan.
She's pretty, isn't she?
Yeah, she is.
She does
and
have
she's
bought,
a star.
And she has
she does have,
clothes.
And she really is.
Has worn
a
auntie, I'm sure.
I think she just
I think every star is as good as their stylist. Their fashion quotient.
I think that's the way.
If you have a crap stylist, they look
you're
like
finished.
Crap. If they have a good stylist, they look terrific.
Who do you think has a great stylist? We have a long list.
Actually, you know, the thing is, I think some of them have multiple stylists. Because I see sometimes from the males that come into the office, one person will have two or three. So I think they use them. The ones who use them intelligently will get the right look. And I don't think they may necessarily get the right look all the time.
Yeah.
But they will get it.
Okay.
X amount of
time. We move on to Deepika Padukone.
I think she carries everything quite well.
Yeah.
All right, Ranveer Singh.
I don't know, a combination of hit or miss, I guess. Sometimes yes, sometimes no.
Yeah, it's two different extremes, actually.
And a bit anxious.
Ayushmann Khurrana.
He's quite cool, no?
Yeah.
He's cool. I mean, I think also a lot of it is dictated by their cinematic image. Yeah. We tend to read personalities by the way they perform on screen.
Right.
So I think in his case, because he comes across, I mean, whatever I've seen of his work.
That he plays or in
acts. I mean, he's
basically.
Like a good actor.
Yeah.
So you automatically assume, okay, so he's going to be better dressed. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Thank you so much for your comments on Bollywood and their fashion quotient. What is your idea of grooming?
For ourselves or for you?
For yourselves.
Okay.
Or for men, because, you know, when we interview people, there are very few people who have who comment on how men should groom with women, you know, it's
the, much more obvious.
Yeah, it's much more obvious and it's a long list. For male grooming, what advice would you give?
A, be clean, bathe regularly, shave, brush your teeth,
get your, cut your nails, comb your hair,
pedicure, manicure.
Yeah, just
well groomed.
Clean yourself up. That's the most important thing.
Should glow.
Polish your shoes. What, always polish your shoes.
Polish your shoes and glow. You spoke about. So can you give us some tips on male skincare?
Oh God, for the very good diet. As everybody's all into this health thing. I think it's got to do with that as well.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Glow comes with diet.
It's always a good diet.
Gentlemen, the next question is, take us through three different ways of draping a sari.
Three different drapes. One here we have, which is a straightforward drape.
But interesting, but tied very interestingly with the blouse, because it's a wrap blouse.
Yeah.
So part of it goes inside the front wrap. And this has been an extremely successful style for us because it fits everybody because it's a wrap blouse. And you can also wear it with other, you know, with trousers and with jeans and with skirts, not necessarily with a sari.
Yeah.
So that's one. Two. Yeah, maybe take one of these. Can you do that? Yeah.
We're looking at
wearing a little shirt with a bandhani sari, which you can wear. What is the way when you...
The Gujarati way.
It looks kind of
Sidha
cool.
Palla.
Right. With a shirt.
Okay.
That gives it, it makes it a little, you know.
I just want to show this because it's really quite...
Yeah, the leaves and all that. Yeah, it's really, yeah,
yeah.
We recommend this, which is a combination of diagonal stripes. Also very flattering. The diagonal, nothing more flattering than a diagonal stripe.
All right, good to know. According to you, who is the one actor and actress who pull off your clothes the best?
Man, that's a difficult one.
For a man, we have...
I think Ayushmann Khurrana wears our clothes rather well.
Yes.
And even the other guy, what's his name?
Irfan Khan.
Irfan Khan. He's been wearing
these
some of the...
These gentlemen really wear these.
They wear this, also things which are slightly edgier,
yeah.
You know?
Wonderful. Which are your favorite outfits at the store?
I think what's rather beautiful are these... this short top team with these dhoti pants. That's quite a smart look.
Yeah, this sort of embroidered chanderi fabric.
All right.
And that's very cool. I think that Wi-Fi one is very... This thing
oh,
you got,
take
we,
us through
Yeah,
it.
We got that woven in Benares on the brocade looms. The motif was inspired by technology.
Yeah.
So we use the Wi-Fi symbol as a motif.
It's a cutwork process.
Yeah, actually. It's a very elaborate process.
What's your advice for the modern bride?
Don't overdress. Wear something comfortable and break all the rules. You don't necessarily have to dress up, you know, head to toe all glimmery and shit, you know. And dress so that you look like, you know, you're not going to expire under the weight of the jewelry and the clothing.
That's so true, actually.
Yeah. Cakes, wedding cakes.
Okay. If you could take us through some clothing options for a man and a woman going to a wedding weekend, which would include clothes for the wedding, a mehndi, and cocktails.
Maybe you can take out some of the jackets. I mean, we have some really nice unconstructed menswear jackets and bundies, which actually look... which work very well. Yeah, that's, you know, you. I think this
works quite well, which is, it was a silk quilted kurta for a man and a waistcoat, which is again, tripantota quilting.
So this for the wedding and this for the cocktails?
Yes.
And what would you recommend for the mehndi?
Well, that should be something that's fun. So it could be anything from Shripula, this
that
works
nice.
Quite well because that's quite, I mean, if the man is comfortable wearing a shirt and a pair of trousers and jeans, and then you have a kurta and churidars.
Inspired by news, it's been taken from a newspaper.
Narrow pants.
And it's also been very good for us, I mean, you know, in commercial terms. And it's on silk cotton.
And if you could take us through three options for a woman.
I mean, the two options are very short top, which could be paired with a pair of black pants, narrow skinny, and this again is a jacket.
And this has also
sequined.
Been sequined, negative sequins, and this is,
which
you know, calligraphy.
It's like
a combination of Tamil, Malayalam, and Devanagari scripts.
Very cool. So this would work well for a mehndi?
It's more, I think it could be more for cocktails. Could
All
be
right.
for that. Well, there's an option that one could wear this in a double e-cut technique in silk, which has an edging in gold. And this is, interestingly, the color is in pink and orange. Which is
I think
quite,
this is more shadi, maybe no black.
More so for the wedding and thing.
You know,
and
modern graphics.
The scale
graphics.
Of it, the way it changes from a large scale to a smaller scale.
I am very motivated. Thank you so much.
It was a pleasure.
With that, it's a wrap. Thank you so much for watching and we'll see you again on another episode.